Hi guys, this is Abhinas and you are welcome to another video of Easy Tutorials. Today in this video, we will learn how to make a social media website design like Facebook. We will make this social media website template using HTML and CSS step by step. As you can see on my computer screen, this is the social media website design that we are going to create in this video, and this website design looks like Facebook. On this website, you can see first, we have a navigation bar with logo, some icons, one search box, and one user profile image. After that, we have some contents in three columns. In the left sidebar, we have some shortcut links with icons. And in the right sidebar, we have some events, one advertisement image, and online users list. In the middle column, we have list of stories or status. After that, there is a post section where I have added one input box to write text. Below that input box, there are some icons to upload image or video, one icon to go live, and one icon to tag activities or feelings. After that, we have list of post with post description, image, and like, comment, and share icons. At the end, you can see a button called load more, and in the footer, we have a copyright text that is Easy Tutorials YouTube channel. When we scroll this website, you can see the top navigation bar, left sidebar, and right sidebar is not scrolling. They are fixed at their position. When we click on this user icon, it opens a drop-down menu with some links and icons. In the drop-down menu, you can see I have created a toggle button. Let's click on this button and you can see it will change the website to the dark mode. And if I click again, it will change the website back to the light mode. We will create this drop-down menu, light mode and dark mode switching option using simple JavaScript. So keep watching this video till the end to create a social media website design using HTML, CSS and JavaScript. And I will request you to like and share this video. Can I get 10,000 likes on this video? Please let me know in the comment section. Now let's start this video. Here I have this project folder. And in this folder, I have another folder called images. And here I have so many images and icons that I will be using on the website. I will give the link in the description where you can download all these images. Now I will open this folder with the code editor. Here I am using VS Code. You can use any code editor. So here I'll create one new file. Let's click here. And I will give the file name index.html. And here, let's add the basic HTML codes like this. And let me add a title here, social book, easy tutorials, YouTube channel. Next, we will create one more file. Click here and add the file name style.css. Here also we will add some codes, margin 0, padding also 0, font family, let's add Poppins, sans serif. So this will be applicable for all the HTML elements. Next, we have to connect this CSS file and HTML file. So in this HTML file, here we will add link tag, link rel style sheet href. And here, let's add the file name, which is style.css, like this. Now the HTML and CSS file is connected. Next, you can open this web page. Just come back to the folder and open this file with the web browser. You can see the background is completely white because we have not added anything in the HTML file. So let's come back. I will close this one and let's come to the CSS file. Here in the CSS file, we will add a background color for the body. Adding the body tag, and let's add the background. Here we will add this background. It will be a light gray color. After that, if I refresh the website, you can see a slight changes in the background color, which is light gray. Let's come back, and in this HTML file, first we have to create one navigation bar where we will add logo, some icons, and one search box and one user's profile image. So within this body tag, we will add all the HTML codes. So first we will create one navigation bar. For that, we will use nav tag like this. In this navigation bar, we will add two columns. In the left column, we will add logo and some icons. And in the right side, we will add one search box and one user icon. So let's create two div here. I'll add the div with the class name nav left. So it will be for the left column, and let's duplicate it. And here we will add nav right. It will be for the right side column. And in the left column, let's add one logo. So for that, we will add one img tag. img. And here in this src, we have to add the file path of the logo. So you can see here we have this images folder, and after that we have this logo.png. So we have to add the complete path. So let's come here. Here we will add folder name first, images slash then file name, which is logo.png. I will remove this alt tag like this. And let's add one class name for this one. So let's add the class name logo. It's fine. And after this logo, there will be some icons also, and we will add three icons. So let's create a list here. For that, we will use ul tag, and in this ul we will add li for the list. And in the first one, let's add again one image, img, file path images slash, and it will be notification.png like this. Let me duplicate it because we have to add three icons here. So it will be inbox.png, and the next one is video.png. So we have added one logo and three icons in the left column. Now in the right side, we have to add one search box, and we will also add one user icon that we will do later. Let's refresh the website right now and let's see. You can see this logo here, it is in white color, and these icons also, it is in white color. If we will change the background color, then it will be visible clearly. Let's come back and copy this nav. For that, we will add the CSS properties. So come to the CSS file, add this nav tag here. Here let's add the display flex, and align items center. I have a separate video for beginners HTML and CSS where you can learn all these CSS properties, because I don't want to explain the same CSS properties in each of my video. If you are an absolute beginner, then I will recommend you to watch that video first, and I will put that video link in the description. So let's add the other CSS property, justify content. It will be a space between. Now we will add the background. Here we will add the color code. Like this. And after that, if I refresh the website, now you can see these logo and icons clearly. Next, we will add some space from the left side and the right side. And there will be some space from the top and bottom also. So let's come back, and here we will add padding. In this padding, we will add 5 pixels. So the 5 pixel space will be from the top and bottom. And let's add 5%. So we will get 5% space from the left side and the right side. You can see we have some space from the left side. Now we have to set the width for the logo, and also we will add CSS for the small icons which is in the list tag. So let's come back, and first we will copy the class name logo. Let's add it here with a dot because it is a class name. And for this one, let's add width. So the width will be 160 pixels. It will be fine. And we will add some space from the right side. So for that, we will add margin from the right. So the margin right is 45 pixels, like this. Let's refresh the website. You can see the logo size has been reduced. Next, we have to take these icons and this logo in the same line. For that, let's come back and we will copy the class name nav left. Write it here, and here also we will add display flex and align items. It will be center. After adding this, you can see these icons and this logo is in the same horizontal line. Next, we have to make it horizontally. Right now it is vertically aligned, these small icons. So let's come back, and here we will add the class name nav left, and in this nav left we have UL, and after that we will add LI, like this. Here let's add list style none, and display it will be inline block. So it will be horizontally aligned. Next, we have to set the size of the small icons. So let's copy this again, and after that we will add img, because in this list we have the image. For this img, let's add the width. It will be very small, like 28 pixels, and let's add some margin. So we will add margin 0, it will be from top and bottom, and 15 pixel from the left and right side. That's it. Let's refresh the website and check. These icons looks good, and this logo also. Next, we will add content for the right side of the navigation bar. So let's come back in the HTML file, and you can see we have created a div here with the class name nav right. So in this one we will add some content. So in this one we will add one search box and we will add one user icon. So let's create one div and add the class name search box. Like this. And let's add input. Type will be text, and there will be a placeholder. In this placeholder, let's add search. And with this input box, we will also add one search icon. So before that, let's add one space here. And here, let's add one img tag. And in this image, we will add the folder name / file name. So the file name is search.png. We already have these icons in the images folder. So we have added one input box and one search icon for the search field. And after that, we will add one user icon also. So let's add another div here. And here we will add one class name. For this div, we will add the class name, let's say nav user icon. It is fine. And in this div, just add one img tag, img, and folder name / the file name. So the file name is profilepic.png. We have added the search box and one profile picture. Let's refresh the website. You can see it is coming like this in the right side. So we have to set the size for this user icon, and we have to align everything in the horizontal line. So let's come back and we will copy this class name navwrite. For this one, we have to set the display flex. So you can see in this nav left, we have already added this thing. So let's add one comma here, and we will add the another class name, which is navwrite with a dot like this. So now we have display flex and align item center for the right column also, which is navwrite. Let's see. It is coming in the same horizontal line. Next, we have to set the size. So let's come back, and in this HTML file, you can see we have added this class name nav user icon. So just copy this one and after that we will add img, because here we have the icons with the img tag. Here we will add the width, it will be 40 pixel, and we will add border radius, it will be 50%, so that the image will be circular, there will be a round image. Let's add the cursor pointer. You can see small user icon in the right side, and it is in circular shape. Now we will add the CSS for this search box. So let's come back. In this HTML file, you can see we have this class name search box. So let's copy this one and add it here. For this one, let's add the background. So the background will be this one. And after that, we will add width. It will be a fixed width. Let's add 350 pixel. Then we will add border radius. Border radius will be 20 pixel. And display flex. Align items, it will be center, and we will add some padding. So the padding is 0 and 15 pixel, 0 from top and bottom and 15 from left and right side. After that, let's copy this again, and here we will add img, because we have one search icon in this search box. For that, we will add width 18 pixel. Refresh the website, and you can see the search box width has been increased and this search icon is there. Now we have to add the CSS for this input box. Okay, so let's come back and copy this class name again, then write input, because we have one input field in the HTML file. So let's add the CSS properties for this input. We will add width. It will be 100%. Then background, it will be transparent like this. Then let's add some padding of 10 pixel. It will be enough. And outline will be none. Border will be 0. So after adding this, if I refresh the website, you can see this search box looks good, but now we need some space between this search box and this icon, which is user icon. So let's come back and let's see where we have the class name here, nav user icon. So let me add a space here. Here only I will add, and we will add some space from the left side. So let me add margin left. 30 pixel will be enough. Refresh the website, and you can see there is some space between these user icon and this search box. Next, we will add one small green dot that will so the user is online or user is active, like that. So let's come back, and in this HTML file, come to this div nav user icon. With this one, we will add one more class name. I'm adding the class name online because that icon will show the user is online. Copy this one and come to the CSS file. We can do this with the same class name nav user icon also, but we are using the another class name because we have to repeat this in the other part of the website. So we will just use the online class in the other places and we will get the same design. Let's add this class name here, online, and for this one let's add the position relative and add this class name again, and let's add after. We will use the pseudo elements, which is after. So in this one we will add content, so the content will be empty like this, there's nothing. Then let's add width and height. So width will be 7 pixel and height also 7 pixel. Then let's add border, so the border will be 2 pixels solid, and color code, which is FFF white color. Then we will add border radius, so the border radius will be 50%, it will be a circle. Then we have to set the position. Before that, let me add the background. So the background color is 41db51, like this. And next we will add the position, it will be absolute. Then let's add top 0 and right also 0. After adding this, if I refresh the website, you can see a green color of dot over here on this user icon. So we have added everything in this navigation bar. Next, we will create 3 columns here, left column and right column, and the center one where we will add the main content. So let's come back to the HTML file, and you can see we have started this nav tag here and it is closing here. So after closing of this nav tag, we'll add some space, and here we will create another div with the class name container. And here in this container, we will create 3 columns. So let's add another div and they write the class name left sidebar like this. Let's duplicate it, and this will be right sidebar, and the second one we will add some other class name. Let's add main content because it is not a sidebar. So we have the left sidebar, main content, and the right sidebar. You can't see these div right now. If I refresh the website, there is nothing. So let's add the class name container in this CSS file. And for this container, we have to add display. So the display will be flex, like this. And we will add justify content. So the justify content will be space between, and we will add some space from the left side and right side and from the top also. So let's add some padding. We'll add the padding of 13 pixel from the top and bottom, and from the left and right side 5%, like this. Next, we will add the CSS for the columns. So let's copy the class name left sidebar, write it here. For the left sidebar, let me add one background here so that you can see the width of the column. So let me add the color code like this. and we will add flex basis. Flex basis, it will be 25%, like this. And we will add position sticky, because these left and right side columns will not move, it will not scroll, it will be sticky, like this. And we will add top, so the top will be 70 pixel. Whenever we will add the sticky, we have to add the position from the top. Then let's add align self. Align self, it will be flex start. Now we will add the same thing for the right side also. So just copy this one, add it here, and here we will add right. It will be right sidebar. Now we will add the CSS for the middle one, which is main content. Add it here. You can see we have added 25% space for the left one, 25% space for the right one. Now we have 50% space available. So for the main content, we will add only 47%. Flex basis, 47%. So the rest 3% will be space between these columns. So let me refresh the website. There is nothing over here because we have to add height also. So let's come back, and here we will add height. I will add the height 100 VH, and for the right one also we will add height this one. Now you can see the left column and the right column. You can see the top navigation bar is scrolling whenever I scroll the web page. So it should be fixed. It should not scroll. So let's come back and come back to the nav CSS where we have added the nav tag, this one. And here we will add position. So the position will be sticky. It will be sticky at top 0, and let's add Z index. It will be 100. After that, if I refresh the website and scroll this one, you can see the top navigation bar is not scrolling whenever we scroll the web page. The top navigation bar is fixed at its position. It's fine. Now we'll remove this height from here. Let's come back, and here you can see in the left one we have added height, so remove this one, it is not required. And here also in the right sidebar, we will remove this height, like this. And next we will add content in the left and right columns. So let's add some space in this left sidebar. Let me add some comment here so it will be clear. Here I'll add left sidebar. So the left sidebar HTML code is starting from this line. Let's copy it and paste it here. It will be main content. And paste it here. So it will be right sidebar. So right now we will add some HTML elements in the left sidebar. So in the left one, we have to add some links, and for that we will add one div. And let me add the class name. I will add the class name IMP links, important links. Like this. And in this link, we will add one anchor tag A. And I will add hashtag here. We can add different page link here. Then in this link, there will be a text and one image also. So I will add one img tag, images folder name, and the file name of the image. So the file name is news.png. So we have added this image, Next we will add text also. So the text is latest news. Like this. Next we will add other links also. So simply copy this A tag and paste it again. So let's add the other image here. It will be friends and the text also friends. Then the next one is group. Now the next one, it will be marketplace. And let's add one more. It will be watch.png and the text is watch. After adding this, if I refresh the website, you can see these links in the left side. Next, we have to add the CSS properties for this one. So let's come back. So let's come back to the HTML file and copy this class name, IMP links. Come to the CSS file, add it here. For this IMP links, important links, we will add one A tag because we have added anchor tags over there. And let's add text decoration. It will be none. Then we will add display. So the display will be flex and align items. Align items, it will be center. Then we will add some margin from the bottom. So the margin bottom will be 30 pixel and we will add color. So this is the color code. After that we will add width. So the width will be fit content. Like this. Next we will copy this one and paste it again. And you can see in this HTML file, in this A tag we have this img. So let's add img over here. And for this image we will set the width. So the width will be 25 pixel. And let's add some margin from the right side. So let me add the margin of 15 pixel, like this. Next, if I refresh the website, you can see it looks like this. Next, we have to remove this background color that we have only added to display you that we have a column here. So let's come back and in the left sidebar, you can see we have added this background. So let me remove this one. It is not required. And we will remove this background from the right side also, like this. And now it looks like this. Next, we will add one more link at the bottom over here. So let's come back and in this HTML file, after this A, let's add one more A tag. And here we will add only one text. So the text is see more. Like this. And if I refresh the website, you can see it is over here. Next, we have to add a color for this last link, which is see more. For this one, we will add one color. So just come back and we have to select this anchor tag. So in this CSS file, you can see we have added this IMP links A. So just copy this one. And here we will add last child. Like this. So it will select the last anchor tag. And for this one, we will add color. So the color I'm adding this one. Now you can see color for this last link, which is see more. Next, we will add one line over here at the bottom. So let's come back and copy this one. IMP links. And for this one, we will add border from the bottom. Border bottom, it will be 1 pixel. Solid and color, which is CCC gray color. Now you can see a horizontal line over here at the bottom. After this horizontal line, we will add some other links also with the small images. So let's come back in the HTML file. After this div, which is closing here, here we will create another div. So let's add a div here with the class name. I'll add the class name shortcut links. Here we will add one text. So let me use the p tag for the paragraph, and I will add the text your shortcuts. After that, we will add some links with the image. So to create a link, we'll use the a tag, which is anchor tag. And in this one, let's add image. Images file path. So the file path is shortcut1.png. And we will add text also. So the text I will add web developers like this. Next, copy this one and add it again. And it will be shortcut 2, 3, and 4. And here we will change the text. It will be web design course. Next, we will change this text. Full stack development, and let's change this text also. Website experts. Refresh the website, and you can see these images and links here. Next, we have to add the CSS properties for this one also. So let's come back and we will copy this class name shortcut links. Copy this one. And we have to add the same CSS which we have applied in this one, IMP links. So let's add one comma here, add a dot, and add the class name shortcut links. Shortcut links A. So these CSS will be applied for this one also. Let's check. Now it is looking like this. Next, we have to set the size of these images. And we will also add the CSS for this p tag. So let's come back and copy this shortcut links A, write it here. And after that, we will add img. And for this image, let's set width. So width will be 40 pixel. Then we will add border radius. So the border radius I'll add very small, which is 4 pixel, and we will add margin from the right side. So it will be 15 pixel. After that, you can see it looks good. Next, we have to add the CSS for this P tag, which is text written here, your shortcuts. So just come back and copy this one and write P. For this P, we will add some margin. So let me add margin of 25 pixel. It will be from the top and bottom, and let's add 0 from the left side and right side. Then let's add the color. So I will add the color, this one. And after that, font weight, it will be 500. Now this text looks good. So we have added all the contents in the left column. After adding all the content in the left sidebar, we will add contents in the right sidebar. And in the right sidebar, first we will add one title. So let's come back to the HTML file. And you can see the right sidebar is starting from here. So this is the div with the class name right sidebar. Add a space here. And here we will add one title. So let me add one div with the class name sidebar title. And in this one, we will add one text in H4. So the title is events. And there will be one link also. So let's add one A tag. And in this A tag, we will add the text. So it will be see all. Like this. And after that, let's copy this class name, sidebar title, come to the CSS file, add it here. And for this one, we will add display. Display will be flex. Then align items will be center. And justify content, it will be space between. Let me add some margin from the bottom. It will be 18 pixels. Just copy this again and write H4 because we have added the title in H4. So for this one, we will add font weight. So it will be 600. And after that, we will add font size also. So the font size will be 16 pixel. It's fine. And let's copy this again. And here we will add A because we have also added one A tag in the sidebar title. For this anchor tag, let's add text decoration none. And we will add the color. So I will use this color. And after that, we will add font size. It will be very small. So the font size will be 12 pixel, like this. If I refresh the website, you can see this events and this see all. Next, we will add one background color on the right sidebar. To add background color, let's come back and you can see we have added the right sidebar over here. Right sidebar. So in this one, we will add background. So let me add the background of white color, FFF, which is white. And we will add some padding also. So let's add padding of 20 pixel. And after that, we will add border radius. So let me add the border radius of 4 pixel. After that, we'll add one more thing, which is color. So this is the color code. After adding this, let's refresh the website. You can see white color for the right sidebar and this title, which is events, and one link, see all. Next, we will add some events in the right sidebar. So let's come back in this HTML file and you can see this div is closing here. Sidebar title is closing here. So after that, we'll add some space and let's add another div here. So here we will create one div with the class name event. And In this event, there will be two columns, left one and right one. So let's add one div with the class name left event and duplicate it and change it as right event. Like this. In the left column, we will add event date. So let's add H3. Date is 18th. And let's add span. In this span, we will add month, March, like this. Now, in the right side, we will add event name. And for that, we will add the title, which is H4. So the event name is social media. And after that, we will add one small text also. So for that, we will use p tag. And in this p tag, we will add the location of the event, Wilson Tech Park. Like this. And after that, there will be one link also. So for that, let's add one anchor tag. And link text will be more info. Like this. After that, if I refresh the website, you can see the date, then event name, location, and link. Next, we have to add CSS properties for this one, so it will look good. So just come back and copy this class name event. Come to the CSS file, add it here. For this event, we will add display flex. Then we will add font size. It will be 14 pixel. Then we will add some margin from the bottom. So the margin bottom, it is 20 pixel. After that, we will add the CSS for the left column of the event, which is event left. Let's see the class name. No, it is left event. Add this class name, left event. And for this one, we will add border radius. So it will be 10 pixel. Let's set height and width. So I will add the height of, let's say, 65 pixel. Width also same. Like this, and we will add margin from the right side. . 15 pixel of margin, and we will add padding from the top. 10 pixel. Text align will be center, and position it will be relative. Then let's add overflow hidden, and we will add box shadow 00 and 10 pixel, and then color in RGBA format. So here we will add 0 and 0.1. So after that, refresh the website. You can see it is here, 18 March in the left side and other information in the right side. Next, we will add the CSS properties for this P and this A tag. So let's come back and copy this one, event, then write P. For that, we will add font size. It will be very small, 12 pixel. And let's add it again. Then write A. For this A, we will add font size. Again, we will add 12 pixel. And text decoration, it will be none. Then we will add color. So this color code. Now you can see the right side, it looks good. Next we will add the CSS for this span where we have added the month. So let's come back and let's copy this class name left event. And in this left event, come back to the HTML file, you can see in this left event we have this span. So write this span here. And for this one, let's add the position of absolute like this. Then we will add bottom. It will be at the bottom 0 and left 0. Width will be 100%. And we will add background. So this is the background color. Then add the color. It will be white. Then font size, it will be 10 pixels. Then let's add padding. So the padding, I'm adding 4 pixels from top and bottom and left right 0, like this. And if I refresh the website again, you can see it looks good. Right now you can see the height is looking bigger than the width. So let's come back and come to the top. Here we will add box sizing. It will be border box. It will be for the all the HTML elements. Now this event looks good. Similarly, we will add one more event. So let's come back and just duplicate this event. Select this event from here and paste it again. And for this one, we will add another date. So let me add 22 June and let's add the text. Here we will add another event text. Mobile marketing. Let's refresh the website. You can see another event here. Next, we will add one icon over here before this address. We will add location icon. To add one icon, we will use Font Awesome. So open this website, fontawesome.com. Create an account over here. Then click here, kits. In this one, click here and it will give you one script. This one line of script, just copy this one and come back to the HTML file. In this HTML file, add this script in the head tag. Before this closing head tag, add the script like this. After adding this, again come back to the same website and click on icons. In this menu, you can see icons, click here. And in this search box, you can search for any icon that you want to use on your web page. So I'll search for location. And here we'll get different icons. So let me use this one. It is map marker. Now click here and copy this one line of code. Copy this one and come back to the HTML file and paste this icon where you want to display. So I will add this icon before this address. So paste it here like this. And the same we will add here. After adding this, refresh the website and you can see this icon before this address. Now this event looks better. So after adding two events, we will add one advertisement image here, and before that advertisement image we will add one title like this. So let's come back and come back to the HTML file. You can see we have this event and the other event, and before that we have added this sidebar title. So just copy this sidebar title and paste it after this event sidebar title, and here we will add different title. So the title I'm adding advertisement. And in this A, I will add the text close. Refresh the website. You can see another title here, advertisement and close. Let's come back, and just after this sidebar title, we will add one image for the advertisement. So let's add the img tag, write the image folder name and image file name. It is advertisement.png. And here let's add the class name. So I will add the class name sidebar ads. It's fine. Copy this one and come to the CSS file. Add this class name sidebar ads, and for this one let's add width. It will be 100%, and we will add some margin from the bottom. So let me add the 20 pixel margin, and we will add border radius. So the border radius is 4 pixel like this. Refresh the website and you can see one advertisement image in the right sidebar. Now we will add another title here that will be for the users which is active on the website. So let's come back, and in this HTML file let's copy this div with the class name sidebar title and paste it after this advertisement image. And here we will add the different title. So let me add the title here, conversation. And let's add the link. It will be hide chat. Link text is hide chat. You can see this title and this link. After that we will add some users icon and users name. So let's come back, and after this title let's add some space, and here we will add another div with the class name online list. So let me add one div here and add the class name online list like this. And in this online list there will be one user's image and one text also, which is user's name. So let me add one div here, and we will add the class name online that we have already added in the navigation bar. So we are using the same class name online, and in this one we will add image. So I'm using img tag, write the folder name slash and the file name which is member1.png. After that we will add name of that person, that user. So for that we will use p tag, which is for the paragraph. So let's add the name of the user. Like this. Similarly, we will add another user also. So just copy this one and paste it here. Like this. It will be member 2 and member 3. And After that, we will add different name. So let me add the name here. After adding this, refresh the website. You can see three users on the right sidebar with their name and image, and there's a small green color of dot. So let's come back and we'll add the CSS properties for this one. So just copy this class name online list and write it here in the CSS file. For this online list, let's add the display. So the display will be flex, and after that we will add align items center, and we will add margin from the bottom. So the margin bottom is 20 pixel, like this. Next we will add online list, then add the class name, this one, which is online. And in this one, we have the img tag. So write img. And for this image, we will set the width. So the width I'm adding 40 pixel. And after that, we will add border radius. So the border radius I'm adding 50% so that the image will be in the circular style. After that, if I refresh the website, you can see the small icons and their name and this green icon over here. Now just come back and we will add the class name here. And for this online, let's add width. We will add the width of 40 pixel. Then we will add border radius 50%. Like this, and let's add margin from the right side 15 pixel. And now again refresh the website. You can see we have some space, and next we have to move this green color of dot at the bottom corner of this user's profile. It means right bottom of the user icon. So let's come back. And here we will add this one, then write after, because we have added after in the navigation bar to add the green icon, and there we have added the top zero. So let's add the top unset. Here we will do the top unset, and we will add bottom. So the bottom will be zero. So it will be bottom right corner. Let's check, and you can see the green icon at the bottom corner. So it is going beyond the image, so we have to move it up. So let's come back, and here we will add bottom 5 pixel. Let's check. Now it is at the perfect position. So we have added all the users list also, which is active on the website. Right now this title and this title is looking different. It is bold and it is good. So let me fix this one. So let's come back and here we have added font size 16 pixel for sidebar title. So let's come back and copy this class name right sidebar. Copy this one, add it here. And for this right sidebar, we will add h4, and in this right sidebar h4 we have the font size and font weight. So after that, you can see this title and this title looks same. Now it is looking better. So we have added all the contents in the left sidebar and right sidebar. Next we will add the content in the middle column, where we will add the main content like status and new post option and the list of post. So let's come back to the HTML file And in this HTML file, here you can see we have added main content. It is starting from here. So we will add the content in this div, which is main content. Let's add some space, and here we will add the content that will be displayed in the middle column. So in this main content, we will add some stories. So let's add one div here. I will add a div with the class name Story Gallery. Like this. And here we will add multiple story. So let's add div with the class name story. Like this. And we will add some content in this one. So we will add one small image. So let me add img images slash upload.png. So we will add this image, and we will add one text also. So the text I'll add in p tag, it is post story. Like this. After that, if I refresh the website, you can see one icon here, which is plus icon, which is an image, and there is a text post a story in the middle column. Now just come back and let's copy this class name story gallery and add it here in this CSS file. For this one, we will add display. It will be flex, and justify content. It will be space between. Then let's add margin from the bottom, 20 pixel. After that, just copy this class name story and write it here. For this one, we will add flex basis. So the flex basis will be 18% because we will add 5 image. So this flex basis will be the width of the story, but we don't know the height. For that, let's come to the calculator here, and here we will add 16 by 9. So we have to set the image in this ratio, 16:9 ratio. That's why we are adding 16 by 9. So we will get this one, and in this one we will add multiply 18 because we have the width 18. So we got 32, like this. And now we will add this 32 in the height. So we will not add the height here, we will add padding from the top. Let's add the padding top 32%. So it will be a 9:16 ratio. Then we will add position. So the position will be relative. After that, we will add background image. So let's add the background image. Here we will add URL and the image file path. So let's add the images slash file name, which is status 1.png. Next, we will add background position. It will be center, and background size, it will be cover. Next, we will add border radius of 10 pixel. After applying this, if I refresh the website, you can see one image over here. But right now you can see the ratio is not good because of these image and text. So we have to set it as a position absolute. So let's come back. And here you can see this story. Let's copy this one. In this one, we have added one image. So I'm adding the img tag. For this one, let's add the position absolute. We will add width also. Width will be 45 pixel. And let's add border radius. So the border radius will be 50%. It will be round. Then let's add top. So the top will be 10 pixel, and left also 10 pixel like this. Now we will add the border radius. It will be 5 pixel. Solid and this color. Now just copy this story again, then write P. For this one also we will add position absolute. Bottom it will be 10 pixel. Width 100% and text align center. Color will be white. Then let's add the font size of 14 pixel. After that, if I refresh the website, you can see this image ratio is good. But right now you can see this text is not that much visible, so we have to add one layer on this background image. So let's come back, and here you can see we have added background image. So let's add linear gradient, then add comma URL like this. And in this linear gradient we have to add two colors. So the first color will be transparent like this. And in the next one, we will add the color in RGBA format like this. Here we will add this black color with opacity 0.5. And after that, you can see there is a layer on this background image. It is fine. Next, we will add other stories also. So let's come back, and in this HTML file, we'll duplicate this one, this story. Just copy this one and paste it again. We have 1, 2, 3, 4 and one more, 5. So we have added 5 story. Let's change the images here. It will be member 4, member 3, and member 1. Next we will add the name also. After adding this, if I refresh the website, you can see all these stories here. But right now you can see the background image is same in all the stories. So we have to add different background. For that, let's come back, and in each one we will add a separate class name. So in the first one, we'll add one more class name, story1, like this. Next, we will add the class name story2 in the second one. Here let's add the story 3, it will be story 4, and here let's add story 5 like this. Next, just copy the first one, which is story 1, come back to the CSS file, write it here, and you can see we have added this background image. So let's remove this one from here and add it in the story 1 like this. So we have added here. So let's copy this one and paste it again. So it is story 2, 3 and 4 and 5. Now for each one, we have to change the image. So you can see we have added the image here, status1.png. It will be status2.png, 3, 4. And this is 5. After adding this, you can see different images in the story. It is looking good. You can see we have added border here, which is not visible. So let's come back. And you can see it will be border, not the border radius. Remove this one and refresh the website. You can see border. Let's change the color also. It will be this color code. And now it looks good. Now the first one, we have to change the position of this plus icon only for the first one. So let's come back and just copy this class name story, write it here, and with this story just add story 1, because we will add for the first one. And here we have the img tag. Let's add img. You can see we are not adding any space here. It is story.story1 space img. And here let's add the different position for this image. So let's add top unset, because we have added top 10 pixels. So here we will add top unset. And let's add left. Left will be 50%. And then add bottom. I will add 40 pixel. Then transform, translate x, it will be minus 50%. So it will be horizontally center. Then we will add border 0. There will be no border. And let's set the width. It will be 35 pixel. Now you can see this plus icon over here. Now we have completed this story section for this web page. After completing this story section, we will create another section where user can post anything on this website. We will add one input box, and with that we will also add some icons, like icons to upload videos or photos, and icon for going live, and icon for activities. So let's come back and come to the HTML file. You can see we have created this story gallery. So let's see where it is closing. It is closing over here. This is story gallery. Let's add some space here. Here let's create one div. I'll add the div with the class name write post container. We have to create so many classes, that's why we are adding this much long class name, so it will be easy to remember. Write post container. And in this one, first we have to create one user profile. So let's add one div with the class name user profile. Like this. In this user profile, there will be one user's image. So let's add one image. Like this. And after that, we will add user's name, and there will be some other information also, like post going to be public or hidden. So for that, let's add one div. And in this div, first we will add the name. So let's add the p tag, and in this p tag we will add the name. After that, we will add small tag And in this small tag, I'll add public. After adding this, if I refresh the website, you can see this user's image, name, and this text, which is public. Now just come back and copy this class name, WritePost container. Write it here in the CSS file. Now for this one, let's set width. It will be 100%. Then we will add background. So the background will be white like this. Then we will add border radius. It will be very small, 6 pixel. Then I will add some padding of 20 pixel. Then let's add color, and color will be this one. Next, come back to the HTML file and you can see we have the class name user profile. Write this class name here. And for this one, let's add display. Display will be flex and align items center. Now just copy this class name again and write img, because we have added one image also, and for this image we have to set the width. So let's add the width of 45 pixel. Then we will add border radius. So the border radius will be 50% to make it circle. Then we will add margin from the right side, 10 pixel. Let's refresh the website and check this one. You can see it looks like this. Now we have to add the CSS for this title text and this text public, which is in small tag. So let's come back and copy this one, user profile, then write P. For this P, we will add margin from the bottom, minus 5 pixel. Then we will add font weight 600. Let me set 500. And after that, we will add color. It will be color. Now it looks like this. Now we have to add the CSS for this small tag. Copy this one, paste it here. And here we are adding a small. And here let's add the font size. So the font size will be 12 pixel. That's it. After that, if I refresh the website, you can see this text is small. Now we will add one icon also, that will be a down arrow icon. You can see we have this public text here. So after that, here we will add one icon. To add an icon, again we will come to the same website, fontawesome.com. Come to the icons, and here let's search one icon. Let me search for arrow. Let me search another thing, down. Yes, let me click on this one and again click here to copy this icon and paste it here like this. This is the icon. If I refresh the website, now you can see this icon here. So we have added the user's information, like user's name and image and the post option, which can be public or anything. So let's come back and come to the HTML file, and after this user profile, you can see the user profile is closing here. So after that, let's add some space, and here we will add one div. So let me add the div with the class name post input container. So it will be the post input container div, and in this one we will add one text area like this. Text area, let's add the row. So the row I'll add 3 and remove this one, name id calls like this. Now in this text area we will add one placeholder also. So let's add the placeholder. What's on your mind, John? After adding this, if I refresh the website, you can see one text box here. It is like this. Let's come back. So after adding this text area, just copy this class name, post input container, come to the CSS file, write it here. For this one, let's add some padding from the left side and some padding from the top. Let me add padding left. It will be 55 pixels. And we will add the padding from the top, let's say 20 pixels. Then add this class name again. Then write the tag name, which is text area. Copy this one, write it here. And for this one, let's add width. Width will be 100%. Then we will add border. So the border will be 0, and outline also 0. Now we will add border from the bottom. Border bottom 1 pixel, solid, and this gray color, which is triple C. Then background, it will be transparent. After adding this, refresh the website. Now you can see it looks good. There is only one line at the bottom, but in the right corner you can see there is an icon to expand this input box like this. So if you want to hide this one, let's come back. And here we will add resize. Resize none. Refresh the website again, and there is no icon over here. We cannot resize this one. It's done. Next, we'll add some icons below this input box. So let's come back. Come to the HTML file, and after this text area, let me add some space. Let me move it to the left side. Okay, so here we will add another div. Let's add one div with the class name. Let me add the class name add post links. Because we will add 3 links here, and in this one we'll add a tag a. And in this a tag there will be one image and one text also. So first we will add one image, which is img tag, images slash the file name, which is video.png, like this. And after that we will add the text. So here we will add live video like this. Now we will copy and paste it again in this links, and here we will add the different icon. So let me add the file name photo.png, and this will be photo video. and in the third one it will be filling and the text will be filling activity. Like this. Now if I refresh the website, you can see this icon and this text. There's one more icon which is not visible, so let's come back and here we will change this icon. It will be livevideo.png. This icon we will add, you can see. Now we have to add the CSS properties for this one. So let's come back and copy this class name. Here we have added the class name add post links. Copy this one, come to the CSS file, add it here. For this add post links, let's add display flex and we will add some space from the top. So let me add margin top. It will be 10 pixel. Let's copy this again and in this one we have the anchor tag, so let's add a tag over here. For this a tag, let's add text decoration none. Then display, it will be flex. Then let's add align items center and we will add color. So this is the color code. Then we will add margin from the right side. Margin right, it will be 30 pixel. Then let's add font size. Font size will be 13 pixel. Now these text looks good, which is in a tag. Next we have to set the size of these images. So let's come back again and copy this one. After that we will add img, which is for the images. And let's add width. So let me add the width of 20 pixel and there will be some space from the right side. So margin right 10 pixel. Now it looks good. So we have created the post option also with this input box. Next we will create the list of posts where we can see the user's information, then post description, post image and the like and comment icons. So you can see this div with the class name write post container is closing here. So after closing of this div, we will create another div. Let's add the div with the class name. I'll write the class name post container. And here again we will add the same profile. Come back and you can see we have created here user profile with the user's image, name and this small text. So just copy this one and add it here in this post container. The same thing we will add and copy this class name post container. Come back to the CSS file. Here let's add the CSS properties for this post container. Here let's add the width, it will be 100%. Then we will add the background, so the background will be white color, triple F. And after that we will add border radius 6 pixel. Then we will add some padding which is 20 pixel. Then we will add color. So this is the color code. Then let's add the margin of 20 pixel from top and bottom and 0 from the left and right side. After that let's refresh the website and you can see another container here with the user's profile. Here we have to replace this thing and its text will be large. So let's come back. Here we have this small, so let me remove this one, and instead of that, let me add a span. And in this span, let me add one date, which will be the post date. Let's add June 24, 2021, and we will also add the time like this. After writing this, if I refresh the website, you can see this time here. Now we have to add this CSS for this span also. So just come back. Here we have this class name, user profile. Just copy this one, write it here, and here we will add a span. And for this span, we will add font size. So the font size will be 13 pixel. Then let's add the color. So the color, I will add this one. Now refresh the website, and you can see it looks like this. After this user profile, we will add some text. So here, let's add one p tag like this, and in this p tag, we will add the text. So let me write the text. Subscribe Easy Tutorials YouTube channel to watch more videos on website development and UI designs. Then let's add one a tag, and in this a tag we will add the hashtag. So let's add as Easy Tutorials. Let me add one more, so just copy this one. And here let's add the another tag, which is YouTube channel. Like this. And if I refresh the website, you can see it looks like this. Next, we have to make it bold, this one, and we will also add one class name here. So let's add one class name for this p tag. Let's add the class name. I'll write post text like this, and for this one we will add one span. Span open and close here like this. Next, just copy this class name post text and come to the CSS file. For this one, we will add color. It will be this color code, and after that we'll add some margin. So let me add the margin of 15 pixel and 0. Then we will add font size. So the font size, I'll write 15 pixel like this, and let's copy this again, and here we will add a span. For this one, let's add the different color. This one. And after that, font weight. So the font weight will be 500 like this. And if I refresh the website, you can see these font text is different and this one is different, and it is bold also. And next we will add the CSS for this hashtag. So just come back and copy this one post text, and in this post text we have the a tag. For this anchor tag, let's add color. So it will be this color code. Then let's add the text decoration, none. That's it. And if I refresh the website again, it looks like this. Next, we will add one image after this post text. That will be a post image. So let's come back. And here in this HTML file, after this p tag, we will add one image. So let me add one img tag and images slash, it will be feed image one. This is the image file name. And for this one, let's add one class name also. So I will add the class name. It will be post img, like this. After adding this image, copy this class name, post img, and come to the CSS file, write this class name here. And for this one, let's set width. I'll write the width 100%. And after that, we will add border radius. Border radius will be 4 pixels. Then some margin from the bottom. So the margin bottom, I'm adding 5 pixels, like this. You can see this post image. Now, after this post, at the bottom, there will be some icons for the activities like, comment, share. This type of activities icon will be there. So let's come back to the HTML file. And after this image, we will add one div. Let's add some space. And here we will add one div with the class name row. Let me write the class name post row. In this post row, we will add two columns, which will be left and right side. And in the left side, we will add some icons. And in the right side, there will be a user's profile image, which will be a small icon of the user's profile photo. So let's add one div with the class name activity icons. Like this. And let's add another div also after that. And here we will add post profile icon. In this one, we will add the users icon, and here we will add the activities icons. So in the first one, let's add one div, and in this div, let's add one img. Images, and it will be like then we will add text, which is a number 120, like this. Now duplicate this one and let's add the another icon. It will be comment. Now the third one, it will be share. share.png and write the different number here, 20. And for this one, let me write 25, 45. And refresh the website. You can see these icons and number here. So let's come back and copy this class name, post row. Write it here. For this post row, we will add display flex. Let's add display flex. Then align items will be center, and we will add justify content space between, like this. Now we will add the CSS for these images, which is in the activity icons. So just copy this one, activity icons, write it here. And after that, we will add div, because we have a div in this one, and then write img. And for this image, let's add width. So the width will be 18 pixels, and then we will add some margin from the right side. So let me add the right 10 pixels. Let's copy it and paste it here. For this div, we will add display inline flex. And after that, we will add align items, center, and we will add margin from the right side, 30 pixel. If I refresh the website, now you can see these icons are looking good. Next, we will add the user's profile image in the right side. So let's come back. In this user profile icon, we will add one image. So let me add the img here. Then let's add the file images slash, it will be profile pic dot png. And after that, if I refresh the website, you can see a big image here. We have to set the size for this one. So let's come back and copy this class name, post profile icon. Write this class name here. And for this one, let's add display flex, then write align items center. Write this class name again, then write img. And for this image, we will set the width. So the width will be 20 pixel. And after that, there will be border radius. Radius will be 50%. Then let's add some margin from the right side. I'll write 5 pixel. If I refresh the website, you can see a small icon here. Small user's profile picture. After that, we will add one icon here. There will be a drop icon like this one. We will add the same icon. So let's come back and let me copy that icon code where it is. It is here. Just copy this one and we will add it here like this. Refresh the website and you can see this icon at this corner. Now we have to add one more icon over here in the top right corner of this single post. That will be a three dot icon. So let's come back. And you can see in this post container, we have added user's profile. So before that, let's add one div and let's add one class name. So I will use the same class name, post row. It is here. So add this class name, post row. And in this post row, we will add this user profile. You can see user profile is starting here and ending here. So just copy this one, remove this one and paste it in this row like this. And in this row, let's add one icon also that we want to display on the right side. For that icon, we will add one a tag. In this anchor tag, we will add that icon. So for that, you have to go to the same website and search for an icon over there. So I already know the name. I'll write it here. Let me copy this one. And here I'll change the icon. So it will be this is the icon. You can search on Font Awesome website. If I refresh the website, you can see this icon over here. Now we have to change the color of this icon. So let's come back and you can see we have this post row. So just copy this one, paste it here. And for this one, let's add A for the anchor tag. And for this A tag, we have to change the color. So let's add the color and this is the color code, which is this one. Now it looks good. So we have created this single post on this page. Similarly, we will add other post also. So just come back and you can see where we have started the post container. Yes, here it is. From here, we have started the post container and it is ending here. So select this post container and paste it again. Paste it again, and now we can change the text here and we can change the date and we can change the image. So let me change the image here. It is feed image 2, and I will also change the text. So I have updated the text here. Like and share this video with friends. Tag Easy Tutorials Facebook page on your post. Ask your doubts in the comments. And then we have the hashtag Easy Tutorials and YouTube channel. Then we have the different image. Let's refresh the website. And after that you can see the second post and the other text here and the other image. Like this, you can go and change the number also. You can change this icon also. Let me change this icon. It will be normal like icon, like.png. You can see the icon has been changed. And let's add some other post also. This is the post container. Just copy this post container again and paste it here. Let's change the image. It is 3. This is 4. And this one is 5. After that, if I refresh the website, you can see the first, second, third, fourth, and fifth post. And you can see whenever I scroll the website, the left sidebar and the right sidebar is sticky. That is not a scrolling. And the top navigation bar is also sticky at top. So we have added all the contents, different post in this main content. And after the fifth content, we will add one button here at the bottom, and that button text will be load more. So let's come back, and here you can see we have the post container ends here. So here, let's add one button. And for this button, let's add the type. So the type will be button. Next, we'll add the button text. Load more. Like this, button text. And we will also add one class name for this button. So let's add the class name. So the class name will be load more button. Next, we will add the CSS properties for this button. Come to the CSS file, add this class name. Here we will add display block, then margin, it will be auto. Let's add the cursor pointer, and after that some padding. I'll write the padding of 5 pixel from top bottom and 10 pixel from left and right side. Then we will add the border, 1 pixel, and solid, and this color. After that, I will add the color. This will be the button text color. So this color code, and background will be transparent, like this. Let's add the border radius also. Radius will be 4 pixel. After adding this, again refresh the website. You can see one button at the bottom, load mode. So after adding this button, we will add one copyright message at the bottom. So let's come back and come to the HTML file, you can see we have the button here and this closing div. After that, we have the right sidebar. Let's come to the bottom and the right sidebar is closing here, and this is the closing tag for the container. So after that, it means at the bottom you have to create, just before this closing body tag, we have to create one div. And let's add the class name. So I'll add the class name footer like this, and in this footer we'll add the text. So I will add the text, copy type 2021, copyright 2021 Easy Tutorials YouTube channel. After that, if I refresh the website, you can see this text at the bottom in the left side. Now we have to add the CSS properties for this one. So just come back and copy this class name footer, write it here. And for this footer, let's add text align. So the text align will be center. Then we will set the color. So this is the color code. And after that, we will add some padding. So let me add the padding 10 pixel from the top and 0 from left and right, and 20 pixel padding from the bottom like this. And I'll set the font size 13 pixel for this copyright message. Now you can see this copyright message at the bottom in the center. Easy Tutorials YouTube channel, like this. So we have added all the contents. Now next we will add a drop down menu here. Whenever we will click on this user profile icon, it will open a drop down menu. We will create the drop down menu in this navigation bar, and whenever we will click on this users icon, then it will open and close the drop down menu. So let's come back to the HTML file and come to the top where we have created the navigation bar. So let's come to the top here. You can see we have this nav tag where we have created the contents in the nav bar. So before this closing nav tag, let's add some space before this closing nav tag, and here let's add one div. And let's add the class name. I'll write the settings menu. Before that, let me add one comment so it will be clear. It is settings menu. And in this settings menu, we have to add user's profile. So let's come in the post. You can see somewhere we have added user's profile right here. Just copy this one and come back to the settings, which is settings menu, and paste it here. User profile, then profile image, then div. And in this div, we have the p tag where we have the name, and remove this small. Instead of that, I'll add one a tag. And in this anchor tag, we will add one text. So let's add the text. See your profile, like this. If I refresh the website, you can see it is coming here. This is shifted here and this one is here, like this. So let's come back and copy this class name settings menu, write it here in the CSS file. For this settings menu, let's set position absolute. Then we will add width. So let me set the width 90%. It will be for the small device, and let's set max width. All right, 350 pixels. So the maximum width will not increase 360 pixels for large devices. And for now, let me add height. I'll write the height of 500 pixel like this. And after that, we'll add the background. So let me add the background white color like this. Then we will add box shadow. So this is the box shadow, and after that we'll add border radius. So the border radius will be 4 pixels like this, and overflow hidden. Here we will add top 100 pixels. After that, add right. Let me write 5%. Refresh the website, and you can see this settings menu here, and we have to move it up. We have to reduce the top position, and the right side, it is perfect. So let's come back, and here you can see we have added top 100 pixel. So let me add 80 pixel. It is moving up. So let's come back. I will write it in percent. So let me write 100%. So it is coming just after this navigation bar. So we need even more space. So let me increase this one. I'll write 108%. Now it is good. So we have set the position for this drop down menu. Now we will add the other content in this one. So just come back, and here we have added user's profile. So let me duplicate this one, and in the second one we will add text, which is give feedback. And here we will change the text. Help us to improve the new design. And here we will change the image. So let me remove this one, and here I will add the feedback image. Feedback.png. Refresh the website. You can see another icon here, and the text and the link. Next, we will add the CSS properties for this one. So just come back and copy this class name user profile. Write it here, and then write A for the A tag. Let's add font size. I'll write the font size of 12 pixel. After that, we will add color. So let me add the color. This one, and text decoration, it will be none. It looks good. Next, we will add some padding in the menu. So we will not add the padding in this settings. We will add another div. Let me add a div here with the class name. I'll write the settings menu inner like this, and add this one in this settings menu inner. You can see we have the class name settings menu, and inside that we have the settings menu inner. Then we have the user profile and user profile. Now just copy this class name, settings menu inner, write it here in the CSS file, and here we will add padding 20 pixel like this. Now we have some space, and after that we will add one line between these icons. So just come back and you can see this user profile is ending here. So let's add a space, and here we will add HR like this. We will add this HR tag, and we will add this HR after this one also. After this user profile, it is closing here. So here also we will add this HR like this, and come here, copy this class name, settings menu, write it here, then write HR. For this one, let's add the border 0, then height, it will be 1 pixel, then background, this is the color code, then margin, let's add the margin of 15 pixel from top and bottom, and 0 from left and right. Now you can see this line is there, it is not working. Remove this extra dot and see, it's fine. We have some space also, and this horizontal line, it looks good. Next, we will add some other icons here. So just come back and come to the HTML file, this user profile, and this HR. After this HR, let's add some space, and here let's add another div. I'll write the div with the class name. Let's add the class name setting links. Like this. And in the setting links, I'll write one image and image file path. So it will be a settings icon, settings.png. Then we'll add one class name for this one. So let's add the class name. It will be settings icon. Settings links and settings icons, and after that there will be a link. So in this link we'll add one text. So the text is settings and privacy like this. In this A tag we will add one icon also. So here let's add a space and add one img tag, and let's add the image file path, and here let's add the icon name. So it is arrow.png. For this arrow we will add width. So let me write the width, it will be 10 pixel. Refresh the website and you can see this setting icon, this link, and this arrow. Now just duplicate it. Let's copy this setting icons and paste it again. We will change the icon, so the second one will be help.png and the text help and support. Like this, and after that we'll add another icon which will be display.png, and here let's set the link text display and accessibility and after that I'll add one more icon, it will be logout.png and the text is logout. Refresh the website and you can see other icons also. Next, we have to add the CSS properties for this one. So just come back and copy this class name, settings links. Come to the CSS file. Write it here with a dot. And here let's add display. So the display will be flex and align items center. Then we will add margin. It will be 15 pixel and 0 like this. Then let's add the same class name again. Then just copy this class name. Settings icons. Settings icon. Write it here, and for this one let's set the width. So the width will be 38 pixel. Then we will add margin from the right side. So the margin right is 10 pixel. Then we will add border radius. Border radius, it will be 50%. After adding this, if I refresh the website, you can see these icons size is small. Next, we will add the CSS properties for this A tag. So just come back and copy this class name again, settings links, then write A. For this A tag, we will add display flex, and we will also add flex. Flex, it will be 1, like this. And after that, I'll add align items. Align items will be center, and justify content space between. Let's add the text decoration. It will be none. And now we will add the color. So this is the color. Now you can see these icons looks good. Next, we have to remove this height. You can see there is an extra height. So let me remove this one. Just come back and you can see we have added height 500 pixel. So just remove this one. And you can see now the perfect height for this one. So next we have to add the click function so that it will hide and display this drop down menu. For that, we will use a simple JavaScript. So just come back, and in this HTML file, we can write this JavaScript in the same HTML file at the bottom over here before this closing body tag. But the same JavaScript we have to add in the other pages also. Suppose we will create other pages, then we have to add the same script in the all the HTML files. So it is better to create a separate file for the JavaScript. So let's come here and I'll create another file. I'll write the file name script.js. So the file name is script.js. Now we have to connect this script.js file. So before this closing body tag, we will add script src and write the file name, which is script.js. Now the HTML file and this script file is connected. Next, we have to add the click event in the icon, which is in the navigation bar. In this navigation bar, you can see we have this nav user icon. So in this one, we have to add on click. So let's add a space here after this class name. I'll write on click. Here we will add one function name. Actually, we will call a function whenever we will click on this div. So let's add one function name. I'll write settings menu toggle. like this. So I have added onClick equal to settings menu toggle. So it will call this function. So next we have to define this function. For that we'll come back to the JavaScript file. Here we have created this one. So here we will add function and write the function name like this. So whenever we will click on that div, it will call this function. Next, we have to change the height of the setting menu. You can see we have this settings menu here. So we have to change the height of this one. So we will store this element in a variable. So just come back and here we will create one variable and write the variable name. All right, settings menu like this, and then write document dot query selector. document.querySelector and write the class name. So just come back and copy this class name, settings menu, write it here. Now in this setting menu we have to change the height whenever we will click on the icon. So come to the website again, and you can see if I refresh the website, this setting menu is visible. So we have to hide this one first. So just come back and come to the CSS file. So in this setting menu we have to add the height. So we will not add the height, we will add max height. Max height, it will be 0. After adding this max height 0, you can see this drop down menu is hidden. Whenever we set the max height 0, the drop down menu is hidden. So just come back. With this one we will add transition also. So let me add the transition for the max height, and it will be 0.3 seconds. And after that, let's add one class name also. Simply we will create one class name. So let me add the class name, settings menu. Height. This class name is not used in the HTML file. Simply we have written this class name in the CSS file only. And here we will add this max height, and in this max height let's add the 450 pixel like this. Settings menu height. Now what will happen whenever we will click on this icon, we have to add that class name, which is settings menu height. We will add that class name in this menu, so the height will be 450 pixel. That we will do using JavaScript. So come back to the JavaScript, and here let's add that variable with settings menu, then write dot class list dot toggle like this. And in this toggle we have to add the class name. Which class name? This one. Settings menu height. Just add this class name here. And after adding this JavaScript, refresh the website and click on this user profile icon. Now you can see this menu is open. If I click again, it becomes hidden. So you can see this open and close menu is working fine. This drop down menu is working fine. So we have completed this drop down menu design also. After creating this drop down menu, here we will create one button that will be a toggle button. We will use this toggle button to switch between dark mode and light mode of the website. So to create a toggle button here, let's come back to the HTML file. And here in this HTML file, you can see we have created this settings menu div. So within this div, let me add a space here, and here only we will add another div. For this one, let me add one ID. So I will add the ID darkbtn. Here I am using ID because it will be easy to access this for the JavaScript, because we have to add JavaScript on this button. Next, we will add one span like this. Now we will design this button. So let's copy this ID and we will add the CSS properties for this one. So come to the CSS file, write this ID with a hashtag, and here let's add the position. So the position will be absolute, and after that we will add top 20 pixel and right, let me add 20 pixel. So this button will be in the right top corner of the settings menu. Then we will add the background. It will be gray color, CCC. Then let me add width of this button. So I will set the width 45 pixel, and border radius, it will be 15 pixel. Then I will add some padding. So let's add the padding 2 pixel from top and bottom and 3 pixel from left side and right side. After that, we will add cursor pointer like this. And next, we will add CSS properties for this span. So let's come back and copy this ID. Then write span. For this span, we will design it as a small circle. So let's add the width. It will be 18 pixel, and height also same. Next, we will add background. So I'll add the background of white color like this, and then we will add border radius. So the border radius will be 50%. So it will be a circle. And after that, let's add display. Display will be inline block. So after adding this, let's refresh the website and come to this setting menu. You can see this button here. Now its alignment is not looking good. So let me come back, and here we will add display. Display will be flex. That's it. Refresh the website again. Now it is looking good. Next, we have to move this small white circle to the right side whenever we will click on this button. So this circle will move from the left to right side. Then again we will click and it will move back to the left side. So let's come back, and here we will add this ID again. And after that, let me add one class name. I'll write the class name darkbtn on like this. We have not used this class name anywhere on the HTML file. We have just written here, and then we will apply this class name whenever we will click on the button. So for now, let me add padding from the left side. So the padding left is 23 pixel, and then we will add background. Background will be black like this. And here in this one, darkbtn, we will add some transition. So let's add the transition. Transition we will add for padding left. For this padding left, I'll add the transition 0.5 seconds. And after that, we'll add the background also. For this background, same 0.5 seconds. After adding this, just copy this class name and come to the HTML file. And here, if we will add this class name like this, here we have added this class name, and if I refresh the website, you can see this button is on. This small white circle is in the right side, and if we come back and remove this class name from here, and you can see now this button is off. This white circle is in the left side. So now we have to apply this class name through the JavaScript whenever we will click on this toggle button. So let's come back to the HTML file and copy this ID. We have to store this element in a variable in JavaScript. So come to the JavaScript file, JS file, and here you can see we have added this code for the drop-down menu. The same thing we will do for this toggle button. So let's add another variable here. I'll write the variable name darkbtn like this, and after that let's add document.getElementById, because we have added id like this. Now just copy this one, and here let's add btn.onClick. Equal to function, and in this function we will add the class name on this btn. So let's add this variable again, then write class list dot toggle like this, and in this toggle we will add the class name that we have written here, dark mode on. Add it here like this. So now what will happen whenever we will click on this dark btn, it will add this class name, and if we will click again, it will remove this class name. So let's check this on the website. Refresh the website and I will click on this button. You can see it is moving right side and this button looks on. Let's click it again and it is off. So this toggle button is working fine. Next, we have to add the dark mode on this website, and the dark mode and light mode switching option will work with this button. So let's come back and we will come to the CSS file. Here in this CSS file, just come to the top and let's add some space here. Here we will add colon root like this, and in this one we will define colors in a variable. So write like this, I'll write body color and write the color code. So this is the CSS variable called body color, and where we have stored the color code, this one. And now you can see in this body we have added the same color. So instead of this color we can write this variable. So just copy this one, and here we will add like this, where, and this one, and let me add transition also. So I will add transition for the background, and it will be 0.3 seconds. And similarly, we will add another variable also. Let's add another one, nav color. And here I will add another color code, which is this one. So this is the color code for this variable. Next, let's add one more variable. I'll write bg slash color, which is for background color. And here let's add this one, white color, like this, and just copy this one, nav color, and we will add it here in this nav. You can see we have added this same color code. So instead of that we can add where, like this, Now where we have added the background white, that place we can add this one, BG color. So let's scroll down and check. In this right sidebar we have added white color, so let's replace this one. Let's scroll down and check where we have added that color again. So here in this write post container, here also we will add that variable. And next we will add it in the post container here. So everywhere we have added this background color. If I refresh the website, there will be no changes in the color code. You can see all the colors are same when we are using the CSS variables. Now we have to change that variables whenever we will click on any button or a toggle button. So just come back and here let's create another class name. I'll write the class name. Dark theme, and here we will change its value. Copy this one, paste it here. So in this body, let's add the other color code. It will be this one. And for this navigation bar, we'll add complete 0, and for this background also complete 0. It is complete black. So now we have to apply this class name dark theme on the body tag whenever we will click on the toggle button. For that, just come back to the JavaScript file, and here in this function where we have written dark btn on click, so we have to apply that dark theme on click of this dark btn. Here we will add document.body. Then the same thing, class list dot toggle. After that, add the class name, which is dark theme, like this. Remove this dot, only the class name we will add. And now refresh the website, and you can see if I click on this button, the web page becomes dark. See, this drop down menu is not becoming dark. So let's come back and come to the CSS file, and we have to add this background, which is BG color, in the settings menu. Scroll down and see where we have written the settings menu here. For the settings menu also, let's add this variable BG color and refresh the website again. Let's click on this button. You can see the complete web page becomes dark. It looks good. And if we click again, it is visible. Right now, this button background is not visible. So let's come back. And here we will change this color code. I'll write this one, like this. And if I refresh the website again, you can see it is visible. So now this light and dark mode switching option is working fine. But now you can see one problem. If I refresh the website, it comes back to the light mode. Let's check this again. I will come to the dark mode and refresh the website. It is coming back to the light mode. So we have to fix this one. Whenever user switch to the dark mode, it should be dark mode only whenever people will refresh the website or whenever people will close the website and visit again. It should be on the dark mode only. So let's come back to the JavaScript, and here we will use the concept of local storage in the JavaScript. So Let me show you first how we will use the local storage. To use the local storage, we will write local storage dot set item, and in this set item we will add two values. If we are writing like this, it means we are creating a local storage with the name of theme and the value is light. If we will write dark, then the local storage name is theme and the value is dark. So in this way we create a local storage for the web browser using the set item. And if you want to read the value of that local storage, then we will use this one. Local storage dot get item, and in this get item we will only add one name of that local storage. So the name is theme. So if we will write like this, local storage dot get item, so it will give you the value which is stored in the local storage called theme. We will use this concept to store the dark mode or light mode on our browser. So let's add space here. So first we have to read whether the local storage is there or not. For that we will use this one, and I'll write if condition, and here let's add if local storage dot get item theme equal to light. I'll write double equal, it will be a comparison. So it will check whether the local storage called theme has value light. If the value is light, then what will happen? If the local storage value is light, then it should come back to the light mode and the button should be off. So let's add the JavaScript on this button. I'll write dark btn class list dot remove. In this remove, write the class name, this one, dark btn on. If we will remove this class name, then the button looks off. Next we will add this one over here in this if condition. Here just add remove. Now you can see here we are checking if the local storage value is light, then we will remove this class name from the button, so it will be off button, and we will remove this dark theme class name, so the website will look light mode. Now we will add another condition. So let's add else if, and in this else if we will just copy and paste it, and here we will check it is dark. So if it is dark, then what will happen? Just copy and paste it and it will be add. So if the local storage is dark, then the button will be on. It will add this class name to turn on the button, and it will add this class name to make the web page in the dark mode. And now we will add the third condition. Suppose this storage is not there, this local storage is also not there, we don't have the light mode or dark mode save in the browser, then we will add else. And in this else we will add a default value. So here we will create, you can see here we are just checking, here we will create. So let's add local storage dot set item, and we will add the name which is theme and value light. So this line will be executed whenever people will visit the website for the first time. This will create a local storage called theme and it will store the value light. And this all codes will be executed without clicking on button. But we have to do some changes whenever people will click on this toggle button. So let's add a space here in this function, which is on this toggle button. Here we have to update the local storage. Whenever people will click here, we will update the local storage. So here let's add if condition and add this one. If this is light, so if this is light, then what will happen? It will change it to dark. So let's copy this one and write dark, and then write else condition, copy and paste. It will be light. That's it. So you can see, whenever we will click on this button, first it will check the local storage value is light or dark. If it is light, then it will make it dark, and if it is dark, then it will make it light whenever we will click on the toggle button. So after adding these JavaScript, let's refresh the website, and you can see it is still in the dark mode. Let's click here and click on this one, refresh the website, and it is in the light mode. Let me switch this website to the dark mode, and I will close this browser. And let's open this website again. You can see, whenever we close the website and open the website again, still it is in the dark mode, so it is working fine. So we have completed everything on this social media website homepage. In the next video, we will create other pages, like we can create the chat box, we can create the personal profile page. I hope this video will be helpful for you. Please like and share this video, and also help me to get 10,000 likes on this video, then I will make the other parts of this website. Thank you so much for watching this video.